हेलो।
हेलो, हाउ वाज योर वेकेशन? गुड
हाय हाय प्रीति, गुड मॉर्निंग, गुड
इवनिंग.
इवनिंग। हाय सैम। सो इट वाज गुड
हाय.
बट बिट टाइम, आई एम टायर्ड लॉट। So you guys remember what we had for last 2 weeks, or do I need to just go through them?
Can I ask you a question?
Yes, sir.
Okay. A couple of things. I did send you email yesterday saying that I have a kind of a demo type phase first meeting tomorrow to kind of go through and show some of the basic reporting and talk about the functionality of Tableau. So I was wondering whether you what I did was I asked you for some sort of a PowerPoint, but what I did this afternoon in an hour or so is I create a quick this PowerPoint and let me send it to you. And is it possible to kind of talk? I don't know, Stuti, right? Stuti, is it okay if we talk for 15 minutes on the overall Tableau stuff?
Sure, no problem.
Is that
Please go ahead.
okay?
Yeah, it's
Okay.
okay with me.
Is that okay with you, Ram?
Yes, go ahead. Good.
Okay. I just sent you a PowerPoint there. Could you
Okay.
open that and let's.
Let me tap you.
Go down to.
Yeah, one more. Yes, Sam, I think we are seeing it now.
So if you would go down to so architecture, right? Just if you go, Tableau has a highly scalable entire server architecture, which is like a basically three-tier architecture here, right? What it says entire, okay. Serves mobile client, web client, and desktop install software. That's right? And desktop.
Yeah, entire is possible, Sam. Entire is possible with W also.
Okay. So desktop is authoring and publishing tool that is used to create share view on Tableau server, which is right. The question I have is when you say Tableau server is enterprise class business analytics platform that can scale up to hundreds of thousands of users. When you say scale up, what does that mean? That means more user?
Yes.
Scale up.
Yes,
What
Sam.
about the scales out? What does that mean?
Scales out is one is like a height and one is like a width. Like more complex process or more server process. That is like a difference between core based and user based. So more number of users but less work, or less number of users more work to the server.
Okay, so these are inversely proportional, most probably, like if you do scale up.
No, relation is like height and width. Some people there might be some thousand
Height.
users, but they might not be they might be using only 3 GB or 4 GB of CPU process, whereas only 1% or 2% might be using 3 GB processor, right? So it depends on that.
Okay, I see
In
what you're
your
saying.
laptop, if you see the
Okay,
processors,
that
some
makes sense.
processors will use a huge amount of CPU, right? So like that, yeah.
So processor related is scale out versus the number of users, the capturing to log in at the same time is a scale up, it seems like, right?
Like
Okay.
multiprocessing and multi-threading, such things. multi-threading, multi-processing, multitasking.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Supports high
yeah.
availability. What does that mean? Supports high
availability
availability.
Means it has a backup. It has a backup. For example, when one server is down, for example, one VSQL server is down. So in normal situations, mm-hmm. your visualization should not be shown. But high availability, in the sense, there will be a backup to it. That is a mirror image. So that can be brought in again immediately. So that makes it as high availability.
Is that with a regular licensing? Sorry, is that with a regular licensing or does it come with a special licensing?
No, it doesn't come with the special licensing. It comes with regular licensing only. But it depends on how you configure also. That means while configuring server,
okay.
we can see that. That means 2 to 3 servers will be there at the same time. So if you want a backup mission, it's just like a backup mission, Sam. No much difference to it. See, for example, you are already using
it.
A laptop.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So,
it's secure. It's secure. Is there runs on both physical and virtual machines? So
yes.
install on both physical as well as virtual machines. So, right?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Okay. So could you go down, please?
Yeah. This is all correct. This is all good.
Okay.
Flat files are really flat files. Yeah. Excel is not a flat file. Flat files are notepads and such things.
Okay. This is a line I just take out from the online resources. Fast in memory data engine. Okay. Data connection. Could you just briefly go through?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah,
data connector provide.
So, what is the optimized data connectors means? What you'll say?
Your sound is breaking.
Yeah. I mean, data connectors are there, so we know, we all know what is data connector. What is optimized data connector means, what you will say to them, to your audience?
How would you explain that?
Optimized data connectors in the sense, for example, if your database is too old and too slow, then Tableau can
mm-hmm.
improve its performance based on Tableau architecture by doing those extracts, and not only that, Tableau architecture will interfere in it a bit and it will try to improve its performance. So that
okay.
is optimized data connector. So tell them that, for example, if your database is too fast, like Teradata or Hadoop or such things, so then it will optimize that performance and it will leverage that performance instead of doing that extracts and all those things. So it will try to use the top level speed from the data source itself. That means Tableau will interact with the data source. It's just not just pull and push into Tableau. It will try to analyze the performance of database which it's trying to connect, and it will try to leverage that speed which is available in the data source.
Okay. That is the next question in a live connection itself. If you look at it, data connection connector leverage your existing data infrastructure by sending a dynamic an MDX SQL directly to the source. Database
yes,
rather
yes.
than importing all the data. So when you say
yes.
that, I'm going against Teradata itself, and I see the live performance to be really not very optimal because the size of
okay.
the data itself is big. I mean, which
yes,
which is the case everywhere, right?
Yes, that
that's
is
what
the
I'm
case
doing.
Everywhere.
So it is. I'm putting it here because I see this, right? But it's not leveraging the Teradata power to do. It takes forever to. Do something. Why is that?
Since you have a huge amount of data, you better use in memory. I'm saying, for example,
I see.
If your database is too fast,
then
it will leverage that.
Yeah, in my
That's
case, if
optimized.
I say that, in my case, if I say that, they will ask me to run some live data. You know, that's why I'm kind of hesitant to.
No.
Don't
worry.
Don't
tell them that.
This.
See, it depends on the situation. It depends on the situation, or company to company, it varies situations. So optimized in the sense, it's an interactive mode. Tableau can do query binding, all those things. So it's not in your situation, it's that database is slow, that's why you're leveraging Tableau. Whereas if database is too fast, you leverage that speed of the database rather than use, so that you can develop the.
In my case, the Teradata is the database itself. I can't say Teradata is slow, right? I mean, it's, it's performing really fast compared to SQL Server or any other database. So, okay, I see your point there. Let's move forward. Leave the system. Would you go down to the other page? Let's see. Okay, fast and optimize the connect to your with extract. The data engine can access. So when you say store, the storage of the data itself in RAM, I thought the in memory, it is in a cache memory. Is that right? When we say in case of server, where does it store? Is it in disk? Is it in RAM cache? Where does it store?
No.
Store that.
It depends, Sam. This is not always in RAM, or this is not always in cache. For example, you are accessing different dashboards every second, then you are accessing different dashboards in cache. So in cache, the same dashboard which you accessed 10 minutes back will not be saved. But if you are accessing the same dashboard every 2 minutes or 3 minutes, it will be saved in your cache, and it will give you the output. So it depends. So here in memory in the
system, even though I don't change any parameter.
Yeah. If everything is same, it will try to retrieve the dashboard from cache only, cache or RAM.
Okay. And a couple of other questions beside that is, could you show us a quick, 10 minutes dashboard? How do we do? You will cover that in dashboard class. Could you do like 10 minutes of how to do a multi-source dashboard?
Okay, today, right? You want to see now?
Yes.
Okay.
And also, do you have any other thing besides the slides saying like a the architecture diagram or some sort? Do you have that in your PowerPoint?
I think I can add to this existing one. Yeah. I have to do a bit of searching. I think in Google also you should be looking at the architecture. Right now, I'll just develop some simple ads, and I'll try to show you how to keep them in dashboard. So the second icon, this is worksheet actually. So this is dashboard. So you click on it, the dashboard, the visual, whatever visualizations or charts which you create, worksheets will show up here. So if you double click on them, it will come like this.
Yeah, I'm up to this point. So my question inside,
So if you click the third one, it will play around with this
and put it in different place, right? Dynamic. How do you save this dashboard? First thing, right? You save this and user as in dashboard, and user can click it and just see a dashboard, or they see all this data source, or tab one, tab two,
simply,
and all this.
Control S also, or if you say publish workbook, publish workbook, it will ask for your server name. So it will go to your server, So your dashboard will be displayed in your server. From there on, you can access
only
it directly.
Only dashboard component or everything like this?
Everything will be there. Yeah, everything will be there. But mostly dashboard component. From dashboard, you can go to worksheets also. So you'll see similarly
so
like this.
Can you put some sort of a security?
Yeah. It all depends on how you configure your server.
So I don't want user to see all this different work I did in tab 1 and tab 2. I just want them to see the dashboard itself, right?
Yeah,
so can I do that?
While publishing, you will get various options. While publishing, you will get various options. So those options, after selecting those options, so you can remove, you can hide the worksheets from them. So while publishing the dashboard, so,
oh,
they,
okay.
so that they can see only the dashboard.
So how do you, how can this be interactive? Like user just see the dashboard, right? Can we add a, like,
yeah.
How do you make it interactive? The this dashboard look more,
you can
much
add
static,
bit of filters.
Right?
Yeah. So you can add filters. We have seen parameters also, right? So, for example,
yeah.
I'm adding a region here. Okay, add a region. Say quick filter, or add a parameter. Okay, so like this, the same one you'll see it here also. So we have added to sheet 2, right? So you come here, click on sheet 2, go here, right click on it. So quick filters is here. We added region here. So region quick filter is here.
So see, on this case, right, I did this part as well. So in this case, if this looks like this filter is applied to all two of these objects here in this dashboard, do you, how do you, the layout is kind of, it's,
layout is,
how do you make it
you
to,
flexible, right? So you click on that, you come here, you say floating. Okay, now it floats, this object floats. So you can keep it wherever you want. Now remove the floating. It occupies some space. Otherwise, if you want to reduce its space,
okay. Yeah.
You can do this. You click on floating and you can
so
reduce its space.
One, this video you just show me looks much, it's not big.
Okay.
One other thing I don't know, you mentioned or somewhere I see is more dynamic, like you create a tabular report or one report up top and make that as a filter and you can select
our
best.
Yeah, so you click on this. Okay, you click on this, you right click on it and say users filter. Okay.
Users filter, okay.
So users filter, whenever you click this, this will be filtered out.
Obviously, you have to have both of these coming from, I mean, related data set, obviously, to
Yes.
pass that parameter to this one, right?
Yes.
So other question is, like, in my case, I just have one data set which is really bad, which there is nothing to kind of play around with. And what I did is to show off Excel, you can do a multi-sourcing. I create one more Excel file with A, B, C, D up to Z, and then 1, 2, 3, 4 for as a metric. And I was putting those as in side by side, right?
Okay.
And how would you use this filtering or make it more dynamic in that case? I just have two different data sets, one from the structured data, one from the Excel itself, right? And I'm displaying those two visuals side by side as in dashboard. So how can I make it more interactive? Is there
more interactive in this sense? You use action filters. So when you click on one chart, it will go to another chart, just like this. Okay. So that both charts will be interacting with each other when you are showing to your audience. So that will be one good thing to do. And apart from that, try to use as many filters or parameters. For example, you will be sitting in some central region. Where are you sitting exactly in US?
West.
West. So show, take West and show that data because they will be aware of that data, right? So how it reacts on such things. So take 3 to 4 charts and create a story point. This is story point actually. So you can pull your dashboard here and tell them whenever chairs is highlighted, the sales, based on the dates, tell them that chairs was not doing well initially, and now it's from last 1 year, it's again going down. So only 1 year it performed well, such things. I mean, give a detailed analysis to them and write a story, clear-cut story, like saying that chairs were not doing well. I mean, if you have a database, write a clear-cut story then.
Okay.
So that will help you. Like this.
What is that story one? What is
yes,
that? Is that a something else besides dashboard? What is it?
Yeah, in dashboard. Yeah, in dashboard you can't add a story here. Story is to explain you the scenarios. For example, here dashboard is it will keep on. So it you can keep this always like this. Okay. If you are analyzing
this case, is not analyze this thing, right? This is just for an ad hoc thing.
No, you can productionize this.
Do you
productionize
story as well? Story tab?
Yeah, you can say that. You can
okay.
do that. Okay, so add some story here and annotate also. Annotate will be here somewhere, option will be there if you right click or something. See, annotate is here. So annotate it. Some sales or something is not performing or something. Just write your story, write a point here saying that it's doing well, chase is not doing well from last 1 year. So such things you can do.
Yeah.
Write it. And you can drag them and you can increase its size and all those things are there. Like that. See that? So you can highlight it and you can add colors also. That's not a problem. You can do a lot of formatting here.
Okay. Yeah.
So if you want to add a new caption, add a new caption or.
Oh, one other thing you mentioned. Sorry. Okay. Yeah. Got it.
Yes.
So one other thing you mentioned is there is like a limitation to certain number of attribute in a report or a dashboard and a certain number of metric to report dashboard, right? How many were those?
Come again?
There is a limitation of how many rows or column, let me put it this way.
That
you
is
can
16,
put in the report.
16.
16. 16
yeah,
is a column
dimensions
or
method. Yeah, no, see Sam, from first day I'm saying there is nothing called as row or column in Tableau. You just say swap
okay.
it rows columns
okay.
so both the thing, that's it. Maximum number is 16, that's it, including
eight plus
okay
total of 16 or 16 each up
total
to 16,
of 16
each.
Total of 16
okay yeah.
total
okay.
of 16 okay. Okay, so there's not called as rows and columns, you can swap it all this, okay? So with respect to
yeah.
access rather than with respect to rows and columns, okay? Mm.
Okay, I'm good now, thank you. Yeah, let's go and start our regular system.
Okay. No. So, okay. So, Stuti, what we have seen from last 2 weeks, I mean, it's been a long 4 days. Okay.
Yeah.
So, initially we have seen extract, okay. So, if you don't remember anything or if you have any doubts, please ask me. So, initially we have seen extract. So, extract in extract incremental refresh is very important thing and scheduling, those things are very important. Scheduling we are not seeing, we will see in server. And so, incremental refresh and things are very important. And you can add to your extract. So you can publish an empty extract and then add data to your extract so that it will improve your performance in Tableau. And after extract, we have seen various visualizations, how to convert dimensions to measurements to dimensions, thus such things. And we have seen visualizations, we have seen various visualizations. The most important visualizations you will use in your day-to-day life is scatter plots, line charts, bar charts, maps, heat maps, so books, and very rarely combined chart also. And bullet chart, if you use it, it will be good. And bubble graph, packet bubbles. So remaining things we will not use much, like area or plots or histograms, such things we will not use much. But scatter plot, line, bar, pie, map. App is mandatory, I mean, almost everybody will use it. So these charts we have seen, these are very basic charts and we will use them on our day-to-day basis generally. And apart from that, we have seen filters. In filters, the most important filter is context filter, and you need to know what is the basic difference between context filter and cascading filter. So what is the basic difference between context and cascading filter, Stuti?
Yeah. with the context filter, you can go from one like particular sheet, it can remain consistent with the next sheet. I can do that, and with the cascading filter, it will be like a quick filter kind of apply very quickly.
Okay. And what is a global filter then?
Global will be like when you extract the data, it will apply that time globally.
Okay. So you want to try again, Suti?
Yeah, sure. Refresh my memory. Wrong.
Yeah, what is the difference between context filter and cascading filter?
The one that you gave us the example, the solid gray applying to context filter.
So, Suti, for context filter, you need a hierarchy or you need a relationship between two filters, okay? Like category and subcategory. Okay, it's the difference is it's when context filter or any filter, you apply to multiple worksheets, that's a global filter. It's not the filter which apply to data source.
Okay.
So we have, I think I have shown you that slide, I mean, where it shows the how it works, filters works, the level, I mean, at what level which filter will be applied.
Correct.
So first data source filters will be applied. That is, while connecting to the data source itself, those filters will apply. Okay. That is data source filter. That is the only one which will apply to the data source. Okay. Now after that, extract filter is there. Extract filter is while extracting data into Tableau, that is the extract filter. Whereas context filter is in the worksheet. Okay. And it's not applied to multiple worksheets. It cannot be applied to multiple worksheets. Okay. So context filter, you need a relationship between those two. And the higher level filter, you will say add to context, higher level only. Okay. So for example, you have four levels of filters like 1, 2, 3, 4. For applying context filter, if you are applying context filter on second one, first one add to context. If you are applying the third one, second one should be add to context. So like that. So now in order subcategory to be added to context, I have to go to higher level and say add to context. Now it turns into gray. Okay. Now the next step is after adding higher level to context, you come here and you go to secondary level, okay, or lower level, and you say add values to context, all values in context. It's not it's not only relevant values or all values in database, it's all values in context. Okay, now you see based on the selection here, okay, subcategory options will be displayed. Okay. That means based on the context, based on the situation, what higher level is selected or other filters are selected, based on that the lower level will be filtered. Okay, so to make a sense out of it, apart from that nothing else. So this is context filter. So when you see cascading filter, I'm clearing this. I'll take the same columns and rows so that you will understand it easily. For cascading filter, you need not have any relationship. Okay. For example, region will not have any relationship with subcategory, because it's not part of hierarchy.
Okay.
So say we don't use add to context. Okay. In cascading filter, we don't say add to context. So when you say this, so now it's not added. See that all values are still present there.
Yes.
Right. So it doesn't make any sense. See, though subcategory selected, nothing is displayed here. That means relevant values are not displayed. Relevant values, not contextual values. Because these doesn't make any context here, these both. what I will do is I'll go here and say only relevant values. Now you see that. See that? Okay. What all subcategories are present in that region? It's showing up. That means relevant values based on region, based on another filter. Only relevant values. This is cascading filter. So context filter is a relation should be there, and it turns into gray when you add it, and you say add to context here on a higher level, and you come here on the secondary level, you say add values to context. Whereas cascading filter, you say only relevant values. Okay. That means context filter can be achieved by saying only relevant values also. Okay. Whereas it's not vice versa. That means context filter can be achieved by cascading filter. Whereas
cascading filter cannot be achieved by context filter.
Okay. Okay. So that's how it is. So that is a major difference between context and cascading filters. The only difference is only relevant values or add values to context. And any filter you say this option is there, apply to worksheets, all using this data source or selected worksheets. You take any filter, not only this filter, any filter, if you apply to multiple worksheets, okay, you apply to multiple worksheets like this, okay, all using this data source. So those filters are called as global filters. Okay, it's not specific or it's not a different filter. The same filter, if you apply to multiple worksheets or all worksheets in the data source, you say it as global filter. Okay. It's not a data source filter.
Thanks, ma'am.
Okay. So that is very important in your real-time scenarios or situations. You need to understand it. What is a context filter and what is a cascading filter? Because that makes a lot of difference in real-time scenarios. And apart from that, so what we have seen, parameters. Okay, we have seen parameters, and we can create parameters in two ways. One is in filters, you can create parameters. You say filter here, and you can create parameters here. Create a new parameter. So you can do this, or you can right-click here, and you can say create parameter. So there are two ways, that is two ways of creating parameter. And what else we have seen?
We have seen groups and sets.
Okay, what is the basic difference between groups and sets?
I just remember by example that you have given us.
No problem. No problem. Just go through it.
Yeah, so there is like when you select a group on a very subcategory level, it will represent, and there is a category level. So if you select at the category level, whatever subcategories in that category will represent in that group. And if you select at a region level, only that region will represent as a group. And all dimension will only filter out everything from that particular area. And sets are equivalent to all dimensions group.
Okay, okay. And yeah, I mean, just to keep it formally, groups just creates a dimension member, that's it. It will not create a separate shelf here, right?
Yeah.
For sets, it will be a separate shelf here.
Yeah.
Right? So yeah. For sets can be reused in calculations, right? Whereas groups cannot be reused, but since it's only a dimension member created here, there is no separate shelf for it. Sets can be reused, whereas dimension, I mean, groups cannot be reused, right?
Correct.
Yes. So that is a major difference. And in grouping, there is something called as visual grouping we have done, right? Hello?
Yes, yes.
Hello? Yes. So
hello.
Visual grouping we have done. In visual grouping, so in visual grouping, we have done all dimensions or in a particular dimension. So all dimensions is same as your set selection only, right? Particular dimension member selection, right? So that is groups and sets. So what else we have seen?
That's all. The last one we have seen is sets. Before that,
okay,
with the groups, before that with parameters, before that with filters.
Okay, okay. So which chart will use bins in charts?
will use?
Which chart will use bins? BIN, bin.
I don't know. I think we have not gone through this bin anywhere.
Histogram?
Yeah.
We have created a bin on sales field. You have created a bin on sales field. Create bin. Create bin option will be only available on measures. It will not be available on any dimensions. So bins is should be created for using histogram. So only for histogram we need bins. Otherwise bins are not needed in Tableau. Right?
Okay.
So histogram. Okay. Good. So you install Tableau, right?
Yes, I installed Tableau. I started doing the homework.
Student version. Yeah. I mean student version, right? Okay.
Yes.
So we will try to see blending today. Blending is very important. We are almost left with some 10-15 minutes, and otherwise. Give me a minute, we will see. Otherwise, 10-15 minutes, I think blending is tough to see. We'll see something important. So this is what I was saying about filters, how the order will be. So first extract filters, then data source filters, then context filters, then filters on dimensions, then filters on measures. Okay. So this is how the order works in filters. Okay. So I think I have shown you this, but then duplicate items. Wait, I'm searching for a slide here. Give me a minute. I just want to cover some. So meanwhile, Sam, you have any doubts or anything?
No, I'm good.
Okay.
But I was wondering if you had any slide of some sort that you can send it towards me. I mean, not specific to anything, but I can add something else to what I have going.
Yeah, Sam, slides in the sense that you are seeing, right? So you see my slides. I mean, slides are not really clear. So I just had I just wrote on my own. So what you are seeing is the one which I have. So just to show student. So I don't have properly formatted. If you want these, I can send. But I need some time to format them. So it's not proper.
Not formatted. Too much of, just the information, so that I can go through it and add to the existing one. I don't want you to do work. I will do it, but
No, it's not that. This Tableau architecture diagram, Sam, so this is the one which you should use. It's coming up, wait.
Yeah, I see.
So
one
this
stays.
Is the one. Very big.
Okay.
So this is the right one, so you can use this. Okay. So maybe I thought of going through this in server class, so you'll see it.
Okay.
Okay. And today we'll just go through what are file types and how Tableau will store its extracts and such things. So these are file types in Tableau. So whenever you save a workbook, it will be .twb. That is Tableau workbook. TWB. That is Tableau workbook. Tableau, when you save a file as TWB file, that means you see this. Whenever you say save this one, by default it will be TWB. That means it will not save any data source or data source connections. Such things will not be saved whenever you save it as TWB file. Okay. So whenever you save it as TWB file, so it will not save anything else apart from that workbook. Only workbook will be saved. Okay. So, and bookmarks. Bookmarks is, so when you want to open the same worksheet or dashboard every time, you can bookmark it. That means it will create a favorite link for you. That's it. Apart from that, nothing else. So in that bookmark file, all these bookmarks will be created. Bookmark is BM. So .tbm, that is .tbm file. And packaged workbooks is very important for us, because whenever you save anything, please try to save it as .twbx file if you have too much storage on your desktop. Otherwise don't store, because it will take good amount of storage, because it will try to store along the data source connections also. If there is any extract, it will save the extract also along with your dashboards or worksheets, whatever you worked on. So the extension will be TWBX, whereas workbooks, if you say the workbook, it's only .twb, whereas packaged is .tbx. Okay, so TWBX file stores, extracts any connections, connection details, data source connections details, such things. So it will not save the data source, it will save only the extracts. So that is TWBX file along with your dashboards or workbooks, whatever it is. Okay. And it will save the data as a zip file. So in that zip file, everything will be connected, everything will be there. So zip file will be something like this. You're seeing this? So it will be like this. So if you open it, you're seeing that line? So it will be like this. So it will take some time to open, because it will always, I mean, package workbook contains a lot of information. So extracts and Excel sheets, whatever you use it, it will be there. And data, whenever you send anything to your friends, try to send them as .twbx file, so that they can access to the data also along with the workbook files. Okay. Only if you send workbooks, it will go as image and they can't modify it. They can just see it and that's it. Okay. Data extract, if you want to save only the data extract, that is data extract file, that is .tde file. So the extensions are very easy to remember. Everything starts with T, that is W, and data extract means DE, workbook means WB, such things. So extract is just a copy of extract. It will save the, it will try to save the connections and that's it. So if you publish to server the extract, it will have the connection details of the data source also. Okay. And data source is data source, but it will not save the data source, I mean complete data of data source. It will save the connection files. Okay, so it will not actually contain the data. It will just save the connection details. If you have any extra components, or like you have copy pasted data, or if you added data from other source, such things will be there in the data PS file. Calculated fields, groups, such things also will be there. Okay. So all those things will be there. Package data source. Package data source, again, I told you, right, we have seen package workbooks, and this is package data source. Package data source, it will save along with your extract files, workbooks, dashboards, and if your data source is text file or notepad or Excel, it will save the data source also. That means if the size of the data source is less, it will save the data source. Otherwise, it will just have the connection details. Okay. That is packaged data source. Okay, so these are file types in W. Okay, so we have opened a chart, right? We have opened a .twbx file. So this is the one. So it will save the dashboard along with it. If you can go to any worksheet and you can see it here. It's a data source here. This is an Excel source. Sam, so you asked me, right, how dashboard can be done. You can see this.
Yes.
So this is one real-time scenario where we have done a dashboard here. So when you send to user like this .twbx file. This is .twbx file. Tableau packaged workbook. Okay. So it will open like this. Okay. So your dashboard will open but users can see these worksheets. If you want to hide them, you can hide them. That's not a problem. Okay, you can say hide sheet. Okay, but when they want to unhide it, they can unhide them. Okay, so these are all the worksheets which are used to develop this dashboard. So this is the dashboard. Okay, if you added the story, then it will show the story first. Okay, rather than dashboard. So data source connection and everything will be here only. So data source connection is here, so it will be here only. Okay, so that's how it is. And I'm just closing this, so we don't need this. So again, coming to blending, so I'll just give a brief introduction of blending today, and tomorrow we'll see in detail. So coming to you want to see anything in you want to revise anything? You want to see anything else? Parameters, filters, or anything like that? Sets, groups, bins? Stuti?
No, I think we are good.
We are good, okay. So blending is combining of two different data sources. Total different data sources. It's not even the same data sources. Total different data sources. That is, it just combines the data in the output. It will not combine, join the data. It's just a combine the data. So I'll try to add second data source here. That will be my access. Because there's only one. I'm adding coffee chain here. So I'm going to sheet now. So you are seeing two data sources here, okay? So and please make sure all these data types and data formats, everything is okay. And since we have region here, state is there, area code, everything is here. This is coffee chain. Since I clicked on coffee chain, you are seeing it here. See that orders is different. This is with blending. Whereas if you join, everything will be displayed in a single window. And a plus symbol will be displayed here. Okay, that is join. Whereas this is, since it's a different data source, it's displayed separately. See that? Okay, so it's displayed separately. Now, by default, when you say edit relationship, by default automatic, okay, automatically it joined on state here, okay, it joined on state. If you want to change it, you can change it. Since we have state here, where is the state? State is here, okay. If the name or format or is doesn't matches, it will not join. For example, if I write a different name here, it will not join. I say province, now you go to here, since it has joined, now you see it's not there. So for blending to happen, that is to combine two data sources, the name and format of at least one field should be matching, or data should be matching. If it's not matching, it can't combine, or it can't join two data sources. So it should be matching. In such scenarios, you come here, you change the name of it, or if you want to change the format also, you can change the format also. This is always there. Change data type, those things are always there. Since it's only name here, I'll change the name. So automatically it will try to join. Otherwise, I want to be the same name, and even then I want to use it, I want to join it, then go to custom. Okay, go to custom and you can select any fields here. Okay, you can say ship date here, date is here. You say whatever the date is there. Postal code, product name, market or anything like that. Okay, So if you want to join state with anything else apart from state, like market, such things, you can join. You can join, but data should be matching. This matching, yes, since we already had existing one, so it's replacing that. Since this doesn't work, since market and state doesn't have same values, data values, I'm using automatic only, okay, as of now. And this primary data source and secondary data source keeps on changing. You can keep anything, anywhere, that's not a problem. So first, whatever you click, by default, if you click this, it will be primary. If you click this, this will be primary. To fix it as primary, what you should do is, now I clicked on orders, I'm clicking on sales here. Okay, whenever you see that blue tick mark, so that is primary. Okay, that is fixed now. Okay, so this is primary. You go to second thing, now you say state. Okay, and that is secondary. Orange tick mark is always secondary and blue tick mark is always primary. So here, for secondary every time, you see, for secondary every time orange tick mark will be displayed beside along with cylinder icon. So state is from secondary, that is coffee chain. So that's why here also it's showing up, whereas primary nothing will be showed up. So primary will not show anything, whereas secondary will show an orange tick mark along with the cylinder icon. And apart from that, you see a chain here. Okay, so that means it has joined on state, that is it has blended on state. So the word is blended, so it's blended on state. If you want to change it, you can change it. You say stop it, your data will go wrong like this. Okay, so if you want to correct it, you can say correct it simply. Okay, so by default, whatever Tableau joins on, it will be like this. If you want to change it, or if you want to change the join, you can change the join using edit relationships. Okay, so at a very basic level, this is blending, but if you can't find the columns or if you find some problem with it, go here, change the data type, or if it does, that doesn't work, go to rename, okay, change it. And there is something called as aliases also. Okay, you can change the aliases, but you can't rename them. Okay, renaming is different and aliases is different. I told you in before also, while teaching in second class or third class, because this is very important. For example, here central has alias. If you want to change it, you can change it. Okay, better don't, because, or for example, every state will have some alias, right? So if you feel some, there are some spelling mistakes, or if there is some wrong in it, so you can go here and you can change the aliases. Only aliases you can change. You can't change, rename. You can't rename them, because it's from database. Okay. So we'll go to sheet 2. Again, you see that primary tick mark and secondary tick mark, that is primary data source and secondary data source, it's gone now. Now, if you pull from coffee chain now, sales, see that? Now, coffee chain is primary. Now, secondary will be, you go here and you click on subcategory. There is no matching data to it. I'll try to pull in something else. Okay, state only. So, now you see this, that orange tick mark. Orange tick mark is now secondary data source. Now orders is secondary, that is superstore data. So here coffee chain is secondary, here coffee chain is primary. So you can change it from worksheet to worksheet. So first time what from which data source you pull the column, it will be primary. Okay, by default. If you want to change it, you can change it, you can fix it. That's not a problem. Always you can fix it. Okay. So this is how it is. I mean, we have a lot to blending. So tomorrow we will see in detail how blending is, and in real time scenarios, like how blending questions will come, and if you are going for an interview, and how it can be used in real time scenarios. Okay. So any doubts or anything? This is just a basic blending. Okay. Hello.
Yeah,
Okay.
okay, Ram. So tomorrow time we'll resume with this blending, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. So we have blending still. Yeah. Yes.
One, just one question. Like when we are blending two different databases or data source, that time if we have more than one column common, so automatically
Yeah.
display all the columns, right? Those are that are common in
It will,
both databases.
no, it will try to blend on it. It will show you that chain icon here, like this. So if there are multiple columns also, it will not blend on every column. It will, by default, it will select one column.
Okay.
Okay. Here dates are there, right? But still, it's not blended on date, right? It's only blended on state here.
Correct.
So that's why it will blend on one. By default, it will take some column. If you want to correct that column, you can correct it.
Okay. So that time we have to go to custom. But by default, it will only blend on some one particular column.
Yeah, yeah. But this chain icon, this chain icon, you will see if it is blended, you will see the chain icon wherever there is a common field. Okay. Okay. Common field in the sense it's both name and format. It's just not name, it's just not format. Both should be same. Okay. So if you want to change the name, you come and see change the name to date here. So you'll see blended icon here also. You see this? Wait. In coffee chain, there is something called as date here. Whereas here it's order date. That's why you are not seeing this chain here, blended chain. Otherwise you'll see the chain here also. If you change this name as date, wait, I'll try to change it, rename. If you keep it as date, then you'll see the blended icon there also. See that?
Yes.
It's there, but it's not blended. Only this is highlighted. This is not highlighted. So if you want to blend on it, you can say blend. Got it? So like that. But if there is no matching data, it will not display the data. Okay? So that's how it is. Okay. Okay. So tomorrow we'll see in detail. Okay? Thank you guys. Have a good day.
You too.
Thank you.